everyone. My name is Lauren, or my camp name's Sprout, and I work for the Girl Scouts of Greater Chicago and Northwest Indiana in the Outdoor Program Department. And I'm really excited to be talking to you today about composting. Now you might be asking, what is composting? Composting is a form of waste removal where organic matter, such as food scraps like this orange peel, or natural items found outside like leaves or straw, decomposes and breaks down. In a compost bin are nutrients that come from our food scraps or natural items like leaves are broken down and decomposed, and the nutrients that are inside are brought back to the earth. So instead of throwing your food scraps away in your trash can, which will then travel to a landfill, you should try composting. Again, bringing those nutrients that are in your food scraps back into the earth, because that's where it came from originally. Where most of our food is grown, it takes up nutrients from the ground to help it grow. So why not put those nutrients back into earth and have something else grow from those nutrients? There are multiple ways that you can compost. You can compost inside and you can compost outside. So let's go outdoors and see how an outdoor compost looks. So for outdoor composting, you can use a compost bin that you built, like the one behind me. You can also get a compost bin that you buy at the store, or if either of those are not a great option for you, you can just build one right on the ground. It is important that your compost bin is on the bare ground. This allows those microbes and those organisms that are in the ground to come up and help break down the items in your compost bin. So here's a different view of our compost bin. As you can probably tell, it is overflowing. We have a lot more material now than we originally did when we built the bin. So we have a couple pallets here and are really excited in the next coming months to make it bigger so we can fit even more of the brown and the green material. So what might you ask is the brown and green material? So let's get closer and find out. So here's a close-up of our green material. Our green material can consist of grass clippings or any food scraps that you might have, like vegetables, fruits, coffee grounds, or eggshells. One thing to note that it's really important that if you do put any food scraps in here, that you don't put any of the stickers on. I know sometimes in like orange peels, they'll have the sticker on there. You want to make sure that you remove that before placing it into your compost bin. Now the green material is rich in nitrogen, and that helps the compost heat up and helps the microorganisms grow that help with the breakdown process. We encourage you, if you're just starting off, to kind of stick to these items and try to stay away from adding meat, dairy, or fats. To balance out our compost, we add in brown material that is rich in carbon. This material helps provide a great food source for the organisms that live in the soil that work alongside the microbes that help break down the contents of our compost. It also helps bulk up the compost pile. Oxygen and fresh air is really important when composting. These items can include leaves, branches, twigs, straw, corn stalks, or pine needles. Like you can see here, we have some plants that have died from last year, as well as some leaves from last fall. So when composting, it's really important to layer the green and the brown materials. So as you can see, we have our layer of green materials here, the food scraps, and then you want to add in on top the brown material. You place it on top here, so that it's separated, and it also keeps a nice layer on top of the food to try to keep pests out as well as the smell. One last thing to note is that it's really important to have water and moisture in your compost. Just like oxygen, the moisture helps break down the organic matter in your compost.
So just like outdoors, there are multiple ways that you can compost inside. You can use a big Tupperware bin like this, or you can use a kitty litter container or anything else that has some kind of lid. And it is the same process, is you would add your food scraps inside and you want to make sure and cover it. Very similar to how it was done in our outdoor compost bin. One way that you can do that in your indoor compost bin is if you have some soil in there, you just dig a small little hole, put your food scraps in, and cover it up. Also, again, oxygen is really important. So when you have this container, you want to make sure and you drill some holes in the top and in the sides up near the top and the rim of your bin so that oxygen can get in so that it can properly decompose. Another indoor way to compost is called vermicomposting, and that actually uses small red worms to help break down your food scraps. How cool is that? All right, so just a couple tips for indoor composting. Remember, make sure that your compost bin has holes in it to let the oxygen in. And also, very similar to the outdoor compost bin, we want to make sure that it is moist. So add that water in so that it's almost like the consistency of a sponge. You also want to make sure that you have the brown material as well. So not only add those food scraps in, but add in the brown material. When adding your food scraps into the compost bin indoors, it helps if you break it up into small little pieces. This will help break down your food scraps a lot faster. Thanks for joining me today and learning about composting. If you don't have a compost at home, we encourage you to just try it. Make it small, and then if it's successful, keep building it and see how big you can make it. Maybe you can put as much food scraps as you can and then reduce that amount of trash that you send to the landfill. If you already have a compost, keep up the great work. Thanks so much and hope you had fun today.